Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 3.3, Problem 2. This is Section 3.3, Problem 2. It says, in one particular episode of Monster Garage, Jesse James can build muscle cars and motorcycles. He has 800 hours of painting time available and 1,000 hours of mechanical time available. Each muscle car requires 100 hours of paint time and 200 hours of mechanical time. Each motorcycle requires 100 hours of paint time and 100 hours of mechanical time. Each muscle car has a profit of $20,000 and each motorcycle has a profit of $12,000. How many of each should Jesse build to maximize his profit? So there are four steps just to set this problem up and then four more steps to do the problem. So, in order to set the problem up, step one is identify your variables. So that's an easy step. You want to look for two things that are being made in the problem. And in this problem, the two things that are being made are muscle cars and motorcycles. The muscle cars are mentioned first, so I'll make them X. So up here, let's put X equals, muscle cars. Y equals motorcycles. So step one, identify your variables. We've done that. We've made each variable one of the two things that are being made. Step two is write out your object function. You want to look for information. It's typically about profit, not always. It could be something else like revenue or whatever, but usually profit, and it's usually near the end. And this problem is fairly standard. Near the end, it says each muscle car has a profit of $20,000 and each motorcycle has a profit of $12,000. So to write out your object function, we want to put maximize Z equals, so the muscle cars are X and each one has a profit of $20,000, so it'll be 20,000X plus the motorcycles are Y and each motorcycle has a profit of $12,000, so it'll be Z equals 20,000X plus 12,000Y. So that's step two, write out the object function, which we did. Step three is set up the constraints. So underneath subject, maximize, we'll write subject two. Now the constraints for this particular problem, what's going to limit how many motorcycles, how many muscle cars? It's going to be how much painting time and mechanical time is available. So the painting time, there's 800 hours of painting time. So I'm going to put 800, and we can label that paint, and 1,000 hours of mechanical time, and I'll just abbreviate the, I'll put MECH for mechanical. Now, it says each muscle car requires 100 hours of paint time and 200 hours of mechanical time. So again, the muscle cars are X. So for the paint constraint, we're going to have 100X. And for the mechanical constraint, 200X. Again, muscle cars are X. Each muscle car requires 100 hours of paint time and 200 hours of mechanical time. So next, the motorcycles, which are Y. Each motorcycle requires 100 hours of paint time and 100 hours of mechanical time. So again, the motorcycles are Y, so for paint it's going to be 100Y. And for mechanical, again, 100Y. Again, motorcycles are Y. Each motorcycle requires 100 hours of paint time and 100 hours of mechanical time. Now in between these values, we put a plus. And for each constraint, it is a less than or equal to. If you have 800 hours of paint time, you can use up all 800. But you can't use, say, 806. You just don't have it. So as much paint time as you use, it can be at most 800, 800 or less. And the same thing with the mechanical time. You can use all 1,000 hours of mechanical time or a little less. You can't use more than 1,000. You just don't have it. So step three, set up your constraints. We've done that here. And step four for setting up one of these problems is for each variable used, it must be specifically mentioned that it is greater than or equal to zero. So x being greater than or equal to zero means the number of muscle cars produced can be zero or bigger. The number y greater than or equal to zero means the number of motorcycles produced must be zero or bigger. You can't make a negative number of motorcycles or of anything. So now the problem is set up and it's ready to solve. So I have two constraints, one for paint, one for mechanical. I'm going to graph each one. I'm going to do them in different colors, shade them in, find my corner points. So now the paint constraint I'm going to do in red. So I'm going to make a little XY chart next to my constraint for paint. And I'm going to pretend that my paint constraint is 100x plus 100y equals 800. In terms of just drawing the line itself, I'm going to pretend that's an equation, not an inequality. So find two points that make the equation true. So if I put in a 0 for x, I'm left with the equation 100y equals 800. Well, to make it equal, the y value would have to be 8 to make 800 equals 800. And then if I zero the y to get another point, I have 100x equals 800. Well, if x is 8, 100 times 8 would make 800 equals 800. So the x value would be 8. And now for the mechanical, which I'm going to do in a different color, I'm going to do that in green. I'm going to make a little xy chart next to my mechanical constraint. Same process, pretend it's 200x plus 100y equals 1,000. Find two points that make that equation true. So first, if I put in a zero value for x, I have 100y equals 1,000. Well, y would have to be 10. And then if I zero the y, and I would have 200x equals 1,000. Well, x would have to be 5. 200 times 5 would make 1,000 equals 1,000. And now that I have my two constraints ready to graph, I can choose my number scale. Now, the biggest number I'm dealing with for the y's is 10, and for the x's is 8. So that's not that big. One at a time is certainly a sensible number scale to use for that. I don't have to go by hundreds or anything like that. So I just go up to 10, one at a time. So for the y scale, I'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Because I do have a y value of 10, so I have to go at least 10. And the x's I'm going to run the same. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8's actually big enough. That's the biggest x I'm going to deal with, but I might as well just make 9, 10. That's easy enough. Now, to actually draw them. So the paint constraint, which I've started to do in red, I put the point 0, 8 on my graph. So I go over 0, up 8, and put a red dot at over 0, up 8. Then over 8 up 0 has to go next as a red dot. So over 8 up 0, I have to have a red dot at that point. And now I'm going to connect those with a straight line. Now I have to decide if I want to shade beneath the red line that I put for my paint constraint or above it. So what you do is to pick a test point that's not on the line, use 0, 0 if you can, which I can use because 0, 0 is not on the line, and put it in the constraint you're graphing and see if the result you get is true or false. So for the constraint I'm using, I have 100x plus 100y is less than or equal to 800. If I 0 the x and 0 the y, I'll see that I get the result 0 is smaller than 800. And I decide, is that true or is it false? Well, it's true. 0 is smaller than 800. That means my test point is in the shaded side, which is the underneath side. Now, the other constraint for mechanical time, which I have drawn in green, let me put that on my graph. One point for my mechanical constraint is over 0 up 10. So I put a green dot over 0 up 10. And the other point was over 5 up 0. So I put a green dot at over 5 up 0. I'm going to connect my green dots with a green line. And I have to decide whether I shade below the green line or above the green line. Same process, I'm going to use my test point of 0, 0. Put in a 0 for x and a 0 for y in my mechanical constraint and see if the result I get is true or false. And the result I get is 0 is less than 1,000, which is certainly true. 0 is less than 1,000. So my test point was from the underneath side. Result I get is true when I try it. So I'm going to shade underneath the green line. And I won't even shade above the red line. I know I've got to be below both lines. And then x is greater than or equal to 0 is going to keep me on the right side of the y-axis here. I can only use points with a positive x-coordinate. And y is greater than or equal to 0 is going to keep me above the x-axis. I can only use points with a positive y-coordinate. And now the area that satisfies all my constraints simultaneously is the area that I've shaded. Now, that's the part about graphing the feasible region. Next, I have to label my corner points. The first corner point I have is over 0, up 8. That's a corner point. Coming around, I have one at 0, 0. That's a corner point, certainly not the maximum, but it is a corner point. I have another corner point over 5, up 0. And I have a corner point where the red line and green line intersect with each other, which looks by my freehand graph of over 2 up 6, but you really should check that out to be sure. So what I'm going to do is take the constraint for paint, write it as an equation, the constraint for mechanical time, write it as an equation, and solve them simultaneously. So I should be able to fit it underneath here. So let's do 100x plus 100y equals 800. That's my paint constraint. And then 200x plus 100y equals 1,000. Now I want to cancel one of those variables, either the x or the y. The y seems like it'd be a little easier to cancel. You should be able to choose either one, get the same answer either way. So let me leave the bottom constraint unchanged, and I'll multiply the top one through by negative 1. And that will allow me to cancel the y's. So everything in the top constraint will be times negative 1. So I'm going to do negative 1 times 100x will be negative 100x. Next is negative 1 times 100y will be minus 100y. Then I have equals, and then 800 times negative 1 is negative 800. And the bottom constraint can stay unchanged. 200x plus 100y equals 1,000. Now if I combine those, the y variables will cancel. Negative 100x and positive 200x combine to make 100x. Negative 100y, positive 100y cancel, which is good. Then on the other side of the equal sign, negative 800, positive 1,000 is positive 200. So now if 100x equals 200, I can divide out the 100 and find that x equals 2. So the x-coordinate of the point where the red and green lines intersect is 2. So they intersect at 2 comma something. Now in order to find the y-coordinate, what I can do is take my x value of 2, go back into either of the original equations with my x as 2 and find y. And I should be able to use either one. The top one seems a little bit easier. So if x is 2, I'll have 100 times x is 100 times 2 plus 100y equals 800. So 100 times 2, I'll have 200 plus 100y equals 800. Now bring the 200 over to the right side. I'll have 100y equals positive 800. I'm going to subtract away 200 is 600. And now divide away the 100 in front of the y, and you'll have that y equals 6. So the y coordinate is 6. So I found the x coordinate was 2, the y coordinate is 6. So the graph is accurate enough. This one I probably could have just read off the graph, but now I'm really sure that it's over 2 up 6. Now what I need to do is set up that chart where I systematically plug in each corner point and find the output. And I should be able to fit the chart right in here. Let me do it a little different color so I don't blend in with the other red stuff. Let's go purple for this. So the first column I typically label corner point. Sometimes I just put corner. The middle column, which I leave a little wider, is for the object function, which for this particular problem is z equals 20,000x plus 12,000y. And the far right column I leave for output. Now I have 1, 2, 3, 4 corner points, so I will make 4 rows in the chart that I will fill out. My 4 corner points, one of them is 0, 8. The next one is 2, 6. The next one is 5, 0. And the bottom one is 0, 0. So now plug in the x and y coordinates of each corner point into the object function for this problem and see what you get for an output. So the first corner point, 0, 8, means x is 0, y is 8. So the 20,000 times x becomes 20,000 times 0. 12,000y becomes 12,000 times 8. 20,000 times 0 is 0. 12,000 times 8 is 96,000. 0 plus 96,000 is 96,000. So this is telling me by making 0 muscle cars and 8 motorcycles, the profit you get is $96,000. So now 2, 6 is the next corner point, which again means 2 muscle cars and 6 motorcycles. So 20,000x becomes 20,000 times 2, which is 40,000. Plus 12,000y becomes 12,000 times 6, which is 72,000. So 40,000 plus 72,000 is 112,000. So you can make a profit of $112,000 by making 2 muscle cars and 6 motorcycles. That'll use up your resources. The next point, next corner point 50, corresponds to making just 5 muscle cars and no motorcycles. So 20,000 times x will be 20,000 times 5, and 12,000 times y becomes 12,000 times 0. 20,000 times 5 is 100,000, and 12,000 times 0 is 0. 100,000 plus 0 is 100,000. So that means you can get a profit of $100,000 by making 5 muscle cars and no motorcycles. The 0, 0 means you don't make anything, which of course is going to be 0. So 20,000 times x is 20,000 times 0. 12,000 times y is 12,000 times 0. So you have 0 plus 0, so you have a profit of 0, which is absolutely not the one you want. Now, the problem says maximize. So the possible amounts of profit you can make are $96,000, $112,000, $100,000, or $0. Well, the best bet is you want $112,000 of profit if you have enough resources to do that. So the last part of it, state your solution. You will have maximum profit of $112,000 by making 2 muscle cars and 6 motorcycles. Now again, you could come up with that same result through some trial and error, but this way you get it right on the first try.